sponsored in part by Western Union Instant Replay. Western Union, the fastest way to send money.
First, from Raleigh, North Carolina, weighing 234 pounds to my right, Bob Emery. And ladies and gentlemen, Gary Hart presents from the land of the rising sun, weighing 236 pounds, the Pearl of the Orient, the great Muta.
Hello. Hello again, everybody. Lance Russell coming to you on another great program of worldwide wrestling, broadcasting from the Pavilion in Chicago, Illinois. And what a thrill it is for this program, because my co-host and the big guy sitting right next to me, none other than the Junkyard Dog. Hey, I'm noting right now, you're going to be going against this great Muta in the sensational Music City Showdown on May the 7th. Take a look at him right now. He's deep into concentration, looking right smack at you, Dog. Welcome to the show.
Thank you very much. I'm very glad to be here. I guess he's trying to intimidate me.
Yeah. He gets into this trance and just absolutely does not move. We'll be talking a lot. I know one thing about it. With you sitting beside me, I feel good about not having to worry about Gary. Oh-ho! Hit him with that side kick. I mean, came out as Bob Emery, big muscular kid who is the opponent of Muta. Look at him pointing right at you, Dog. Boy, comes right back at him again. With you sitting here, I'm not going to have to worry about Gary Hart coming over here and bothering us in here.
If he decides to come over, I think we're able to take care of him.
Don't give me none of that wee stuff in there, buddy. I'm counting on JYD to do all that taking. Oh, he hit him with a green miss right in the eye. Look at Emery up there. That's what you got to watch out for. You know him, though, because the guy sitting right next to me, Junkyard Dog, went against his daddy, the great Kabuki, and you beat the Kabuki.
Many times.
And your winner, the great Muta.
They are picking right up on you, pointing right at you. Yeah, he's pointing right at the Junkyard Dog, is Gary Hart. He's giving it to him. Well, take a look now. We'll get a little quicker with him. Boy, he got Emery so quick. Caught him first with that side kick. He set him up, got him soft and coming off. Watch this. A 360 in the backflip, and watch how perfectly he hits smack dab over the middle of him. Good night, and get a 1-2-3, and the winner is the great Muta. Hi, this is Lance Russell, and I got to tell you one thing. We are tickled to death to be here, and I'm one of the reasons is our co-host tonight is going to be Mr. Junkyard Dog. Dog, it's great to have you here, and we just got through seeing this guy, Muta, undefeated, you're going to be facing in Nashville.
Well, you know, Muta is a very great wrestler. I had the opportunity to wrestle his father. But most of all, I'm very pleased to be here on this show. And everything's pointing towards May 7th. And I'm got to wrestle Muta on May 7th. And I got a lot of things I got back in my mind how to take care of this guy.
We're going to get a chance to talk to you more about it. I got to tell everybody, what a great program today. Not only do we have an eight-man match, it's going to have the Road Warriors and the First Family, Gilbert and Steiner, going against the Varsity Club along with Orton in there. But in the main event today, we're going to be seeing Ric Flair, Michael Hayes, going against Steamboat and Luger. We're going to take time out. Be back in just one moment.
In our next match, introducing from Ackworth, Georgia, their opponents from New Zealand, Rip Morgan, and his partner from Tehran, Iran, the Iron Sheik.
Well, there he is, Dog Man. I got to tell you, the Iron Sheik is one of the most exasperating guys in the world. Now he wants to sing the Iranian national anthem, and look, coming across the ring, picking the Sheik up, dumping him down as Steve Casey and Ranger Ross going to work.
Seems like the guy's got the hands pulled out of the Sheik and the man, Big Man Morgan, but I think Casey and Randy Ross saved the whole of their own.
Well, I tell you, this Ranger Ross is one guy that has sure picked up a lot of fans in there, and definitely has been one of those situations where the fans have gotten behind him. He's patriotic, and now Big Rip Morgan pounding away on him. He takes him across the ring. Ross caught that big shoulder. He's down.
See, Ross got to take his time with a guy like Morgan. But Morgan is more experienced, and Ranger Ross got the youth on him. Plus, he got a little bit of that ring knowledge. And Steve Casey's still sort of young, but they got their hands full of it.
You know, Ranger Ross is coming up May the 7th against Butch Reed, and Big Hacksaw may be the toughest guy that he's been in that ring against.
Well, you know, I've been in the ring with Butch Reed several times throughout my career. And all I can say is Ranger Ross is more power to you, be in the best shape you can be in, and may God be with you.
Look at that Ross take that big Rip Morgan from New Zealand back in the ring. Turns it over to Steve Casey. This Dallas, Texas young man has really got himself a physique, and he is quite scrambling. Missing was Rip Morgan in that high crossbody in there, and a 1-2 on it. The Iron Sheik comes over and helps to get him off on a tag. Back to Ross.
Well, you know, Steve Casey, he used to be Mr. Texas. Like you said, a guy got a taken physique on him, and with him and Ranger Ross together, they get their thing down back, and they're going to have us one heck of a team.
You better believe they're working very well together in here. Primarily, they've been single wrestlers. Rip Morgan put the big boot right up and walked. That's the kind of mistake you can't make against anybody and get away with it, particularly Butch Reed when he gets in there with him.
Well, see, he went to the well one time too many, and now Rip Morgan do what he does best. He's getting stopped, and he's going to turn it over to the more of like the veteran, which is Iron Sheik. And you know what the Sheik can have. Anything can happen.
Caught him with that clothesline, and the Ranger's down again. Here's the youngest Olympic wrestling champion ever. For Iran, he won a gold medal in the Olympics, this Iron Sheik. That is admirable, but I'll tell you, his attitude is certainly nice. Ranger Ross better get his act together real quick. They have had him going thus far.
But now they got him down and got him in a heck of a way now. And I pray that he will come up and try to do something against Iron Sheik, because I hate to see him out there with the American flag and then a war veteran and stuff to let Sheik just completely demolish him.
Boy, what a great career in the Rangers. There's a tag once again to Rip Morgan. The Ranger trying to get up on hands and knees, but that's all the farther he got. You know, put right in the head, y'all.
You know, we're a big Rip Morgan. Rip Morgan's a powerful individual down in New Zealand, from down under, they call it. And the guy haven't been around wrestling that long in the league, as far as I know, this is a problem.
Look at this. 1-2.
Miller got him again.
Kicked him off of there, though. Boy, I didn't know whether the Ranger had enough to get that 268 off of him or not.
He got that little bit of ring loss, man. Like you said, when those people get behind you and start pushing you, boy, all he could do is try to give him that last little bit of a kick.
One of the things that irritates me about that Sheik are those pointed toes that he's got in there. Looks like he's loading up and nails Ross right in the midsection there. The Ranger having himself a very slow start. We're 4 minutes into the action, and he has not gotten uncracked in there. Abdominal stretch. The Sheik loves to go for this one. He's a powerful guy. He doesn't have the leg hooked too well, and about the best effort the Ranger could make, maybe hook that leg and get him in a hip toss or a mare, side mare. He's out of it now. Ranger Ross whips into the ring. Comes back and catches him with a foot.
Now he needs to try to make that quick tag to Casey, because Casey's the first man outside, and even though he's young, sometimes that 5 pound will get you.
He's coming at it. Look at him firing the right hand. Puts a foot up, and Morgan slams the old coconuts together. Steve Casey and Ranger Ross coming back to get his nippy's worth in there. As they're spread out in the corners, Casey on the Iron Sheik. And over there, it's Ranger Ross, and Morgan dumped him over the top rope. Casey popped the Iron Sheik over and down. Comes back, puts his shoulder. Down he goes, but as Casey went into the rope, did you see that Morgan slap him with a knee?
That's what you call teamwork. Teamwork.
Yeah.
He went to the well one time too many.
He's outside of the ring, but he got the teamwork all right. Now, look at this. Going for that camel clutch. I'll bet you that's what he's going to go for in there, dog.
I hate that thing, man. I had it put on me several times. And he can dislocate your back in a situation. And believe me, Sheik will do it.
Sits right down on the spine, and partner, I mean, he is pulling up. Could be the submission right here. Referee Teddy Long checking in there with Steve Casey. Is he going to do it? Casey trying to fight it off, but that's going to be it. It will be a victory by submission for the team of Morgan and The Iron Sheik. And there's that Morgan.
Rip Morgan and the Iron Sheik.
Here we go. Take a look at it in slow motion. You see how he'll sit down on that spine dog, as you talked about, rear up on the chin, and he has really got it. Okay, I'll tell you what we got to do right now. Take it to the fans, man. We're going to go to Joe Pedicino Knows.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Joe Pedicino Knows. What a great NWA show we're seeing today, and there's a lot more excitement still to come. I've got some excitement right now for our last three winners in the Music City Showdown contest. We'll be bringing these three people along with friends to the Music City Showdown in just a couple of weeks in Nashville. Congratulations going out to Shuntae Raystraw of Detroit, Michigan, Marianne Cackley of Fort Worth, Texas, and T. Daly of Oak Park, Illinois. They will join our other seven winners and their friends in the Music City Showdown, and we look forward to seeing them at a big NWA weekend in Nashville coming up on May the 6th and 7th. Now, we received so much mail that it just told us that you love contests, so we're going right in to our next one. I told you when we started with Joe Pedicino Knows that I'm here for you, the fans, and I was going to keep you involved in the NWA. We'll take a look at this one. It's called the NWA Grand Slam Giveaway. There are five grand prizes. It's a trip for two to the Great American Bash coming up in July. It's a VCR for your home and a complete set of Turner Home Entertainment NWA home video tapes. That's the grand prizes. Plus, there'll be 10 second place prizes, a trip for two to the Great American Bash. And everyone who enters will get a free copy of the NWA newsletter or a picture of their favorite wrestler. How do you enter? What do you have to do? Postcards only. Put your name, address, and phone number on the back of the postcard, list your favorite NWA wrestler, and mail to the official address that we are about to give you right now. NWA Grand Slam Giveaway, World Championship Wrestling, Post Office Box 105662, Atlanta, Georgia, 30348. We can't wait to hear from you. But right now, what I'd like for you to do is go get a pencil and paper, because I'm going to give you that address again in a few minutes, and in just a few seconds, I'm going to give you an address, the same one, how you can write your favorite wrestler. You know, a lot of my mail this week has been on the situation with Ric Flair and Ricky Steamboat. A lot of people want to know, should this be Ric Flair's last chance to get that title back? And in my opinion, the answer is yes. Ric had a reputation of only giving his contenders two or three title shots at the most, and if they couldn't beat him in that number of times, then he moved on to someone else. Well, I think Ricky Steamboat's done just that. He has given Ric Flair two opportunities, and he hasn't been able to do it. I believe this should be Ric Flair's last chance. If he doesn't win it in Nashville, then Ricky Steamboat should move on. How can you write your favorite wrestler? Let's give you the address. It's the same address, NWA Fans, World Championship Wrestling, at the post office box that you see right there on the screen. And if you send it to me, I'll make sure that your favorite wrestler gets his fan mail right here from Joe Pedicino Knows. Let's take a break, and we'll be back with more right after this.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing from Boone, North Carolina, George South. And from Warner Robins, Georgia, Big Ron Simmons.
Well, there he is, Lance Russell and Junkyard Dog, right here on Worldwide Wrestling as the bell sounds. And partner, we are off and running again, Dog. You know this Ron Simmons, he's a good athlete.
Ron Simmons was All-American down at the University of Florida. And I think he was second-round draft pick. What a heck of an athlete, man, over the years.
Boy, he pounded the South in there. He's going to send him right back to Boone, North Carolina in a hurry. Ron looks like he's a little irritated tonight, dog.
He's a big, powerful individual. I think Ron's sort of mad with the world. Like, you know, he bring out a little frustration.
He's got him up in the big bear hug, and you notice that shoulder right up in that solar plexus, and he is hammering it to him.
Pulling that air right out of him, baby. You're like a balloon. Once the air's gone, you're all butter.
There it is. George South is the man that's putting all the pressure right in the midsection and right there in the back. And look at that Ron Simmons. He is determined. This one is not going to take too long to get with. He's working on George South, holding on to him tight, and South is screaming and moaning.
The way Ron Simmons is showing his teeth, man, like he's at an orthodontist at a dentist office. This shorty, drinking, drowning. And George South don't know what the world's coming to. Uh-oh.
That's one of the ways you can do it in there. You pop those ears on Ron Simmons.
Oh, man, that's smart.
Coming back again, George South takes him, going for a whip. It's reversed on him. Back drop coming right off those ropes. Ron Simmons on top of the game tonight with a leg drop right down on George South. He is still had that little momentary move in there by George South, but that Simmons goes right back
to the bell.
got him up there and pulled it hard.
That's what you call that ring knowledge, man. You know, you start on something, you start on that back, you work on that back, you get the air going out, and all of a sudden, boom, boom.
I am so excited about the action coming up just a week away from about now. That's May the 7th up there in Music City Showdown. You contact your cable operator about the availability of it. By golly, it is going to be something worth seeing. Simmons pulls him out of the corner, sticks him right back up. He's got him, and I mean, got him in good shape in there, too. South trying to fight it off. He does not want to try to get this one up here.
You know, if I was sitting in that situation, I was enjoying South's situation. The nearest thing to me is those eyeballs. I have to go for them, Lance. I know it's wrong, but I will have to do it.
He did it. Racked that knuckle up and popped him. You called it, dog.
Yes,
whip
sir.
Across the ring. Stuck the elbow to him. He thought he knocked him down. He was a little late.
Well, nice job, baby.
Big Ron Simmons rears him up. Pow! One, two, three, and that means all she wrote, my dog. You better believe, in the air goes
the
hand.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, Big Ron Simmons.
Right now, all you NWA fans, stay right tuned for the exciting Western Union instant replay. Look at here. Pounds him down on there. Boom. He drove him in there. I just got to tell you, this Simmons is some kind of a horse. He's got him in trouble. If you want to know somebody that knows how to get you out of trouble, fastest way to get money is get in touch with Western Union.
We've had some great action, and we've still got a bunch to go. This match right here, Junkyard Dog, is an eight-man tag, and what talent and bodies we've got involved. We got on one side the rank, the Varsity Club with Bob Orton, and on the other side, the awesome Road Warriors with the First Family, Gilbert and Steiner.
Well, what a combination that is, man. There's a lot of experience in this ring, a lot of knowledge, and a lot of pop power.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a special eight-man tag event, One Fall. Introducing first, to my left, from Kansas City, Missouri, weighing 262 pounds, Bob Orton. And representing the Varsity Club, first, 310 pounds, Dangerous Danny Spivey. 300 pounds, Steve Dr. Death Williams. And 252 pounds, Mike Rotunda. And now to my right, first, from Lexington, Tennessee, weighing 237 pounds, Hot Stuff, Eddie Gilbert. From Bay City, Michigan, 265 pounds, Rick Steiner. And from Chicago, Illinois, at a combined weight of 590 pounds, the Legion of Doom, the Road Warriors.
Back into the ring, they throw. Rick Steiner goes underneath. Over the top with a press.
Good move.
Beautiful move.
They need to tag out at this point. They need to get in that corner.
Mike Rotunda won't let him get a breather. Pops him with that big right hand. Drills him towards the corner in there. And Bob Orton comes rolling in. Bob takes over from Mike Rotunda. Reversal.
How do you like that new addition to that family there with Bob Orton in there?
Well, he's working it right in the middle. He's got the same kind of temperament as the rest of them.
Oh, yeah, I'm telling you.
Steiner reversed it on him, whipped Orton in there. And Steiner, from his knees, drills that right hand into the midsection. Rick, you got to get to
you
the
need
corner.
To get to that corner.
Plenty of help standing over there. And Animal Hawk and Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert. He just can't get away from the Varsity Club members in order to get over there and make the tag. Steiner fighting his way back. Look at Orton. See how he pulled him to the corner.
There you go.
Jumped him right in there and made the tag on Mike Rotunda, who turns right around, makes a tag on Dr. Death. Big Steve Williams from the top drops down. Axe handles him right straight in the middle of the head. Down he goes as the doc with an angry look on his
face. Dr. Death worked.
Boy, I'm telling you one thing. Look at it in those eyes.
Well, Steiner needs to make that quick tag.
Steiner and Gilbert will be going in the May the 7th act action up there, defending their U.S. tag titles. And Steiner
really needs to get over to that corner. We've said it four times, and he gets the left shoulder just in time.
Well, Doc's going off the rocks again.
Oh, boy. He is about to lose it in there as he almost jumped on referee Tommy Young. Eddie Gilbert saying, come on, do something. Don't let him do that to you. And Orton and Williams double whip him over into the rope. There's a double clothesline, and Steiner goes down. Over the top goes Williams on his way out and turns it back over to Bob Orton. Bob Orton picks Steiner straight up in the air, holding him heavy in there. Is Steiner, a long way from that corner at the moment, balances him up on top of the head and getting ready to dump him. He does with a backbreaker across the knee.
And that was a strong individual. A lot of people don't think that Bob Orton is strong, but Bob Orton's a very strong man. Plus, he's got all that knowledge behind that wicked set of eyes of his.
Been around a while, you got Danny Spivey comes in there. When you're already in trouble like... When you're already in trouble like Steiner, you don't need Spivey in there. Rotunda joins. They go with a double. Look at that one from Steiner.
What a pop!
I mean, you can hear it in the top of the pavilion. Steiner jumps to the corner, makes the tag, and here comes Animal and Hawk. The Road Warriors, the awesome pair in there. Hot stuff, Eddie Gilbert joins the pursuit. All eight men right inside the ring right now. They're hammering away on each other. Gilbert going at Orton. The Doc and Animal. Mike Rotunda trying to leave Hawk over there. Uh-oh, they've got Tommy Young in trouble. Tommy goes out. They threw him on the floor over there, Doc. And now you've got mayhem going with no referee. Pounding away with all eight down on the floor. Gilbert going against Norton in the ring. He saw Rotunda take the foot from Hawk. The Animal back over, choking on Dr. Death. Steve Williams. Spivey whipped across the ring.
Oh, boy.
Hawk put it down.
Okay,
here comes referee Teddy Long. He comes running in. He says, ring the bell. I guess he just stopped the match. What? He raises a hand of the varsity club and declares,
what was that?
Spivey, Rotunda, Steve Williams, and Bob Orton, the winner. How in the world did he do that?
He just ran straight from the back out here and raised a hand.
Raised a hand, and son of a gun, he took off out there now. Boy, I'll tell you one thing.
He's gone bitch.
Teddy, I know it's a tough job. I don't know what in the Sam Hill he could possibly
do.
They were all eight of them in there, dog. You're right, Paul Eller. I sure hope he doesn't. He came in there and raised the hand up and gave the match to the varsity club in Orton.
The winners of this match are the Road Warriors, Steiner and Gilbert.
The dog. He gave the decision to the Road Warriors, Steiner and Gilbert. They are the winners. Take a look right now as we look back at the slow-mo, and you'll see what happened initially on it. Teddy Long comes roaring into the ring when Tommy Young had been knocked down. He takes it upon himself. See him hold up Spivey's hand and then runs out of there. Back in a moment.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, Trent Knight.
Okay, the Hacksaw making his entry in here. Lance Russell and Junkyard Dog sitting right here on Worldwide Wrestling as we're ready to go. Here's another guy that you know very, very well in Butch Reed, dog.
You know, I had men in bouts with Butch Reed. I call him fried and died late inside. I take all the inside. That man is one heck of an athlete.
Boy, he is an athlete and a half, a great football player. The young guy that he's in there with is Trent Knight, has been making some moves of recent, but he has got a heavy hill to climb with Butch Reed.
You know, Butch Reed is looking forward to that May 7th with Ranger Ross. Younger guy on the band until Trent Knight. Keep fighting on down because if you used to lay down that ring for 1 second, victory would power in rescue.
Yeah, and that Butch Reed up there, letting everybody see those big guns he's got in there, walks over, has a word to say to Tommy Young, the referee. We're back into action, dead center of the ring. They tie it up, collar and elbow. Butch Reed has his arm taken by Trent Knight, and Knight turns it over. Reed doubles that fist up. He was going to draw me with it.
See, the first thing Trent does wrong is trying to go upstairs. The man decides that Butch you go downstairs, take the legs away from him, just like a big oak tree. Once you cut a tree at the bottom, you got to do what, Lance?
Golly, there's a man who knows the junkyard dog looking in here as Butch Reed picks Trent Knight up. Had a handful of hair when he got him up, and referee Tommy Young started a count on him. Big hip toss, and over and down goes Trent Knight. Ooh, he'll feel that in the mom.
We can't take none of those, Lance. We better get on up and try to do something.
Trent Knight, the young man, down on his hands and knees, but not for long, because Butch has him right up, snaps him over the shoulder, slips in behind that reverse face lock, as he has really got it. I'm looking at that right hand of his taped up in there. That could do some damage if he decides to cut loose with it.
Well, you know, Lance, who his manager is, which is, Matt Suda.
He goes in there with hero Matt Suda. You go that way.
What Matt Suda got plans for Butch Reed, just like Michael Hayes and all the rest of them. You always have a trick up your sleeve.
Come up there and flash that money around, and son of a gun, I'll tell you one thing. They think it's going to bust. Uh-oh, Reed had his foot on the rope. Not for long. Referee Tommy Young's head was up. He got it off.
Using that street style stuff. Butch Reed's the type of man will put the ooh-wee knot through your hair. Every time you rub one, you holler, ooh-wee.
The dog talking to us about Butch Reed in there, and Trent Knight, handful of hair, took him down. We could see it. Referee's asking him. He thought the way his head snapped back, that's exactly what happened in there. Hey, listen, Joe Pedicino's got the full details on what is the most exciting contest you've ever run across. World Championship Wrestling's Grand Slam contest. They're accepting entries on postcards only. While you're at it, name your favorite wrestler in there. And listen to this. Everybody is going to be a winner in there, dog.
Everybody?
Every single person that enters will be a winner.
That's the kind of contest the old dog like to enter. I might win some.
Yeah, you and me, buddy. Hey, the top prize is going to be a 26-inch color console TV. They got VCRs. But the big thing, everybody that enters wins. Postcards only. Joe will have all the details coming up in a moment or so. Look at Butch Reed. See that hand up there over the referee's back while his head's down.
Smart strategy.
Butch Reed having a hold of Trent Knight in there as we're battling into the action right now, and he is bending that head. Look at that son of a gun work on that neck. See him picking him up, putting his weight, straining on that neck. Butch Reed now reaching down. That son of a gun has got more hands than an octopus. He's grabbing tight hair, doing it all. Butch covering him up. This could be it right here. He is really putting the pressure.
Then again, Lance, you got to give it to Trent Knight, a young kid. He's not giving up. Plus, that Butch Reed using the rope. Anything to win.
I'm glad you said it. He blames me for siding against him, but we both of us saw it right there. He had the foot right up there on the rope, and referee Tommy Young is reading the chapter and verse to him right now about it. There's that right hand.
That fist, that cover fist again. And Reed don't actually need that. But he's looking for the easy way out.
Partner, he is working on it right now. Slams the head of young Trent Knight into the corner. Snaps him out over and down in the middle of the ring. And now, ooh, what a painful one. You've had that a time or two.
Several times. But Lance, you think you're trying to send a message out to somebody? David Ross?
Good point, because they're going to be meeting in there. It'll certainly be Ranger Ross's toughest contest up to this time. May the 7th, Music City Showdown.
And somebody might need the Oak Ridge Award to sing him a song after that, man.
Yeah, that's one thing. You contact your cable company about the availability in there, partner. Not only the great Music City Showdown, but also the Oak Ridge Boys. Butch Reed, big high knee. Put him off the feet. And I'm talking about done. Here it comes, huh? What do you think?
A gorilla slam.
Pressed him up and dumped him down. Where is he going? Climbing the ladder right now.
The big bear is climbing up.
Going to the top in there, and this is one everybody knows if you ever saw Butch Reed.
Well, put your lights out.
That flying block tackle right off there and hammers Knight down on the canvas. Goodness gracious, he pounded him hard. One, two, three. And that, my friend, is another victory for Big
Winner
Butch
of the match,
Reed.
Hacksaw Butch Reed.
Yowza, let's take a look at it in slow motion, because when you see this heavy-duty body come flying off that top rope, imagine what Trent Knight must feel like. Slams him hard. Hey, Joe Pedicino has got all the details on the Grand Slam contest. So right now, let's go to the fans' man, Joe Pedicino knows.
Well, I hope you got the pencil and paper ready, because I'm about to give you the address for our big NWA Grand Slam contest one more time. And we want to make sure that you know that you send a postcard only to this address, and on it you must put your name, address, and phone number, plus your favorite NWA wrestler, and send it to the address that you see right there on the screen, and we will be picking out some winners. Now, we'll have five grand prize winners. They will win a trip for two to the Great American Bash in July, plus a VCR, plus a complete set of Turner Home Entertainment NWA home video tapes. We'll also have 10 second prizes, which will win the trips to the Great American Bash. Plus, everybody who enters will receive a free copy of the NWA newsletter or a picture of their favorite wrestler. So we want to make sure that you are available to be a winner in our contest, and we'll be talking about that over the coming weeks. Right now, I want to do a commentary, you know, a special aside right here to Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. He has been facing, of course, Ric Flair in some great matches. Well, Ricky, you know, we love you, and you're a great champion, but I think it's time to leave the wife and the son at home. This coming match you've got coming up is the most important match in your career. It's Ric Flair's last opportunity, and it's the most important match you've ever faced. Look, we know you do it for your family, and we know you love them. But let's face it, it's for the glory and the money this time, Ricky, and I think that you should take it that way. Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, leave the wife and kids at home. This one is all business. After all, Ricky, we know that you love your wife and son. We've seen it. But I think it's time now for you to step forward and take a step up and say, I am doing this one for Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. You know, your goal in your career has been to be a world champion. You finally made it. Well, friend, don't let it go this time. This is Ric Flair's last chance, and a direct piece of information for you, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. You'll never face a tougher opponent than you're going to May 7th in Nashville. Now, fans, that's my opinion, and that's exactly what it is. It's my opinion. I'd like to hear yours. What I'd like to do is give you an address, and you can send me your opinion on this or any other subject dealing with the NWA, because after all, that's what I'm here for. I'm your contact with the NWA, and you can write to me. I'll make sure your favorite wrestler or Jim Herd or Ted Turner, anyone in the NWA, I'll see to it that they get your comments if you'll send it to the address you see right there on the screen. After all, as we said, this is your portion of the NWA show. We've got a break, and we'll be back.
They're coming right in now. We're talking about Ric Flair, Michael Hayes. They had some comments to make about their opponents tonight, Steamboat and Luger. Here they are.
You know, there's a lot of obvious differences between the Nature Boy, future six times world heavyweight champion, and Michael P.S. Hayes. You might say the meeting of both ends of a different world. But the combination now together, for the first time ever, they said it couldn't be done. And the difference is, how do you follow Ric Flair? I follow him right down that gold brick road. And how do you follow Ricky Steamboat?
You follow him down a bad street, brother.
Because when the two of you,
against the two of us, we're going to beat your brains in. You know what? We won't lose a second of sleep over.
Coming in right now to the ring, two great champions, Junkyard Dog. We're talking about the U.S. heavyweight champ, Lex Luger, and the world heavyweight champ, Ricky Steamboat.
Well, look like to me we got four champions in that ring. Lance, everybody's looking good. It's going to be one heck of a match here.
Waiting on them to get ready to go right now. No belts, just a lot of pride will be
just
on the line.
A lot of pride.
And Flair goes in after him. Steamboat trying to fight his way out of the corner, but Flair drills him with that right hand, and the referee calls he's using a fist. Whips him around into the corner directly. Oh, no. Did he hit him? Ooh, man, oh, man. Drilled the Dragon. And Ric Flair again pounds him again. And referee Tommy Young getting fed up with him using that fist.
Look at the
he
the
dragon. He's got to make a tag as soon as possible.
Yeah, he really does. He is in bad shape. He tries with a shoulder, but you see it didn't have that stuff behind it, dog. Got him straight back over the rope, drops an elbow across him, and the referee's saying, get him off the rope, and he does. Chokes him on that top rope and snaps him off.
Flair really taking a turn right now.
Ric Flair picking the dragon up, and I mean just
mad.
He's wild. I believe he's got him a little wild on Queer Street just about.
He don't know where he is right now.
Look at him staggering. He's fighting by instinct, but he doesn't really know exactly where he is. In the air he goes, and Flair took advantage, reversed it on him. Steamboat was going to, here comes the figure four on the dragon. Michael Hayes trying to keep Lex Luger distracted, and look at Ric Flair grabbing a hold of Matsuda's hand, and he is putting the heat on him. Boy, this is the one thing that he could not make Ricky the Dragon Steamboat give it up when they met in the big action in New Orleans in there, even though Steamboat got a submission out of Flair, but he's got him right now in the figure four. And you know, sometimes you think maybe it would be the wild. Uh-oh, here comes Michael Hayes taking over. They're trying to get the fresh man in. He had no tag. He did not tag him in there. Flair said, yeah, we did. And the dragon down suffered. He's in bad shape. Sometimes I think, dog, you'd be better off to relieve the pressure on that thing, but he just can't let his heart won't let him do it. You know what I'm talking about.
Sometimes you want to give up, man, but you got those people behind you trying to think about what you done, how you don't work so hard to get where you're at. You just can't let it go that easy.
And I guarantee you, it is all and all as they are pounding away.
And they keep going, Lex. Lex got to maintain his cool for a little while. He got two people outside with him against him. It's hard.
Flair makes a tag on Michael Hayes, and they made no mistake. Oh, yeah, that's sweet. Comes over there, slaps him in the face, didn't he? And then kicks him down on the mat like that. Trying to play a head game with him. Just
there you go.
Spins him again. Look at the dragon. One, two. He almost had it. Can I tell you? Steamboat with that pure instinct takes him down the head such as Flair rears back up. And look at that bridge. Can you believe it? How is Flair going to get him on that backslide, trying to take him down where he can get the shoulders down on the mat? And look at Flair. He's fighting.
That's an ex-champion. This is Rick Flair. That's why he's a five-time world champion. And that's why Rick is a dragon champion. Now you got two great individuals in that race.
Look at this. He's about to get him down. Slid him. Count of one. Count of two. And Flair just barely got that right shoulder. Did he nail him?
Still fighting, man.
I mean all the way. Continue. Absolutely no rest for anybody in this match in there. Luger's been outside. Boy, would they love to get him back in there.
He urged him to get inside there, Lance.
From the ropes over here, Flair standing up. The dragon comes over, pounds him. He's going to try to take him off. Ooh, pitches him over and slams him down in the middle of the ring. Oh, now, there's a case where you really think if Ricky had just gone to tag Luger. Instead, he was so, after being beat around so much, his pride said, I got to get him, I got him down. He made that leap at him. The son of a gun, Flair caught him with those legs up in the air.
All right. Makes the tag, and here comes the total package against Michael Hayes.
He's fine, baby, he's fine.
Big backdrop, takes Flair up in the air. Luger dumps him down. Hayes comes in. They exchange rights as they pound away. Steamboat catching that big breath on the side. Flair over there by Michael Hayes caught up. And there's that power slam as he drove him right down into the mat. Dandy move by Lex Luger. He comes back over and he drills Hayes with that right hand.
See? Check out Michael Hayes.
Hey, what's he got on his hand?
Check out Michael Hayes.
You can see it. The referee can't. He misses Luger, though, with it. He took a poke. He's got brass nuts or something on him and slammed him right there in the head. Covers him up. One, two, three. Wait a minute. I can still see it.
I'm telling you now. The scientific man.
Well, he did it. He went deep down in the front. Ripped out. I'm telling you. Referee Tommy Young didn't see it. Tommy, He had it on his hands. Look at that. Boy, smirk is the right description of it, dog. The hand goes up. And son of a gun, Ric Flair and Michael Hayes, with Hayes using that. Let's go back and take a look at it. Now, here comes Luger into the rope. What you can't see is what Hayes has on his hand right now. Luger comes over there. Now you got to look at
there you go.
We got it right here. Referee Tommy Young. I wish he were right here. It's all over with. Look at Luger, man. He is really
missed
out
that first shot.
He missed him on the first shot, but watch what he does. Pump, pump, and there he goes. Rap. Right upside the head. Pounds Luger down, and Lex is still in the center of the ring. Man, oh, man, Michael Hayes, and you're going to do it by yourself.
No.
Oh, yeah, you kidding me. Well, there it is, the winners, Michael Hayes and Ric Flair. Back in just a moment.
Hotline. Now, keep up with the latest breaking action in the NWA by calling 1-900-909-9900. Hear all your favorite wrestlers, plus Jim Cornette's insult of the week.
It's here, Wrestling Hotline. Just dial 1-900-909-9900. Even a moron like Paulie Dangerously can remember 1-900-909-9900.
So if you've only got one call to make, make it the Wrestling Hotline. 1-900-909-9900.
This Sunday, get ready for the shock of your life. Three chilling tales of terror. They hear the rhythm of your blood. They tear the scream from your throat. They make your worst nightmares come true. When the terror strikes.
I'm a werewolf.
Wolfen, an American Werewolf in London, and The Howling. Sunday, starting at 4 on Channel 11.
You're looking for a car. Bronx Nissan is the place where the values are. Everybody honks when they get to the Bronx. No bull. Our price for a center is
$65.99.
And nobody's asking for your advice. $15,989. This Maxima. No bull. We got a first-time buyer program. Bronx Nissan. Hey, hey.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
New Shield deodorant soap is fresher than ever. Feel fresh all day with fresh new Shield. The fresh new way to dance through the day.
Bubble Yum Bubble Gum, full of the big delicious taste that bombs your buds with flavor. It'll pop you nonstop. Bubble Yum keeps it popping.
What a program, no doubt about it. Hey, don't you dare go away, because one of the things that's been brewing has been this big feud between Captain Redneck, Dick Murdoch, and big, tough Bob Orton. Now, they're going to be meeting in a big rope match coming up on May the 7th in the Music City Showdown. Manager Gary Hart had some comments to make about it. Just remember where it's coming from. Right now, let's take a listen to what Gary Hart has to say.
Murdoch, you know by now, everybody knows that you talk a whole lot better than you fight. Because every time you get involved with Bob Orton Jr., you are laid out. Now, all the talk about how big and bad you are and what you're going to do to big Bob Orton just tells me one thing, and the country knows the same. You ain't nothing but a liar, brother. You are a West Texas redneck, and all you could do is talk. And if you've got any guts, come one more time.
Murdoch's got him up. Gary Hart, it's a Gary Hart trip Murdoch. Good move by Orton. Hart trip Murdoch, and Hart's holding Murdoch's foot down.
continue to stomp and kick away and maul at him. Kevin, they're trying to hurt him, and they're trying to permanently hurt him. They will be double-teaming that way.
Participants in here, you'll be one of them. Good luck to you against New
York. Thank you very much, and I'd like to say thanks to all of you.
We gotta go. Bye-bye, everybody.